The Honourable Member for Dartmouth South.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, my question is for the Premier. Today we've heard from the government on the subject of investment, but in a time when women are leaving the workforce in huge numbers, when the early childhood education sector is teetering, when we know the importance of that education to parents, to children, to our economy, the gaping hole in this budget is the failure to invest a single new dollar into affordable, accessible childcare. We know that per dollar, investing in childcare creates more jobs than any other industry. Mr. Speaker, given the need and the clear economic benefit, will the Premier explain why this budget fails to make any meaningful investment in childcare?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And we continue to invest substantial funding in the childcare sector, Mr. Speaker. And as I said in the throne speech, it's a priority for us to have that conversation with the federal government to see where they're going. I believe it's irresponsible to look at investments that may not be the most effective way to leverage a universal health care program. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Dartmouth South.
Mr. Speaker, there are other provinces that have done it. We can do it too. Given the recent closure announcement from a regulated daycare in Dartmouth after more than 25 years, we know the childcare sector in Nova Scotia is not on solid ground. Between February 2020 and February 2021, 2,000 women in Nova Scotia left the labour force. Mr. Speaker, the Premier says we're on the path to economic recovery, but that's only true for some of us. The fact is that compared to men, women in Nova Scotia were more than twice as likely to have left a job in 2020 for personal or family reasons. These women and families are not impressed by conversations with the federal government that have been happening for over a quarter of a century with no results. Mr. Speaker, will the Premier go further than just acknowledging the difficulties faced by women in the recovery and commit to finally implementing a universal, accessible childcare system in this mandate?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And as I said, I've prioritized having those discussions and already have with several MPs, Mr. Speaker. I do believe that we should be working towards that universal child care benefit to Nova Scotians, as Quebec has in the past. I want to leverage that opportunity with the federal priorities. And we were one of two provinces to actually invest in child care over the pandemic to ensure that that sector was stabilized. We're going to continue to ensure that we have a strong economic recovery, Mr. Speaker. And I'm happy to see that women now are back to the employment levels that they were before the pandemic hit. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.